As you collaborate with others in Zoom chat, discussions and ideas will start flying. Let's cover some of the basics so that you can join the conversation. Here is a direct chat message coming in now. It looks like Angela is looking for some information about a presentation I recently delivered. Even though this is a direct message, I'm going to send Angela a threaded response so that I can keep the chat nice and organized. I know exactly where the document is kept, so I'll prepare a quick response to Angela. I'll be sure to use the name of the document so that I give my message better keywords should Angela go searching for it in the future. After some quick formatting and adding in the hyperlink, I quickly send my response. But oh goodness, I misspelled a word. You might consider sending a follow-up message like this with the corrected spelling, but that isn't necessary in Zoom chat. I'll go ahead and delete the extra response and simply edit my original message instead. I'll click on the ellipsis symbol next to my message to edit and fix that spelling error. Next to the timestamp, my message will now show that it has been edited. At the bottom of the chat, I can see that Angela is typing a response. This is helpful to know, so I won't navigate away to other chats just yet. To respond in a more dynamic and potentially informal way, I'll send her a GIF back. Zoom Chat has Giphy integrated natively into the application so that you can easily search for and share a GIF when the moment calls for it. While GIFs can be fun, sometimes a more subtle reaction emoji is a better fit. In this example, Morgan has announced in a channel that a new product will be launching. By clicking on the smiley face with a plus icon, I can choose from my most recently used emojis or click the ellipsis for many more to choose from. Emojis can be a great way to react to a message without posting. I love this news, so I'll give this message a heart as other reactions pop in. I'll also give this post a rocket and a star reaction for good measure. Hovering over an emoji lets you know who added which emoji reaction. Reaction emojis are great, but this one is a little fishy. In this example, Sebastian is trying to troubleshoot an issue with a third-party vendor. Sebastian has done something very smart here. Rather than solicit message responses that cause a lot of unnecessary noise in chat, Sebastian is asking others to respond with an emoji. This will help auto-tally how many others seem to share this issue. Another great way to reduce noise in Zoom chat is to follow the message without commenting. I'll click on the ellipsis icon and choose to follow the message. Now, if any additional threaded responses are posted about this topic, Zoom chat will notify me of each of them. In our final example, Riley has posted some critical links to documents that need to be updated. I'm really busy at the moment, but I definitely want to address the chat message once I'm free. There are two great ways to keep this message front of mind. The first is to mark the message as unread, as if I hadn't even seen it yet. The second method is to bookmark the message. This message is now dynamically added to my bookmarked messages smart collection in the upper left corner. Here, I can quickly see all of my bookmarked messages and jump back to the original post if necessary.